a warm welcome to our Good Friday service this evening. Before we begin our Tenebrae service, we'll just have a couple of announcements to prepare you for the service, and then we're going to enter into a time of prayer and song for Ukraine before we begin our Good Friday Tenebrae service. The bulletin that you have with the black cover on your way out, we just ask that you would hand that back in so it's part of a program that we can continue to use year after year or the next time we decide to do this. Also, as a congregation, you will be invited to take part in some of the songs in the service, and so our director Rolf Anderson will make it clear and obvious when you're invited to sing, so just watch for his direction, and everything you need is in your bulletin to follow along. Some of you received another additional bulletin or just a song, and so tonight, as we prepare to enter into Good Friday, where life and death stand side by side, we have been watching the war in Ukraine, where they also stand with life and death side by side. And so this evening, we'll just take a few minutes. Those of you that have the prayers, you can follow along, and if you don't, there'll be a In Your Mercy, and our collective response will be receive our prayer. We'll do that three times. And then we will sing together the Finlandia tune, This Is My Song, also known as a song of peace. Let us pray. Merciful God, we pray for peace as war rages in Ukraine. Shelter all living in fear. Protect those seeking refuge in neighboring countries. Sustain families separated by the horrors of war. Tend to those who are injured. Comfort all who mourn their dead, and direct your people into the way of peace. In your mercy, receive our prayer. O God, as war between Russia and Ukraine rages, we pray for all hiding, searching for safety, for those forced to take up arms, for all journeying to new lands, leaving behind homes and loved ones, for children surrounded by confusion and chaos, for those in Russia who bravely advocate for peace, for journalists risking safety to report on daily events, for those consumed by the power to dominate and control, that they are filled with compassion for all people, for the difficult work of diplomats, world leaders, and international organizations, for all providing welcome, protection, and sustenance to those who have fled, for medical workers as they attend to the injured, for all grieving those who have died. In your mercy, receive our prayer. Holy One, your strength comes not by grasping power and might, but is poured out in loving service. Support us with such strength to work for peace, to love our enemies, and to trust in your resurrection life, even in the midst of pain and death. In your mercy, receive our prayer. Let us sing together.
Oh, And just to remind you, the offering, which is on the table in the back when you leave, is going to the food pantry to help people in our community in need. Thank you. Let us first.
Blessed be the name of the Lord our God. Oh, please rise as you are able. Start again. Blessed be the name of the Lord our God, who redeems us from sin and death. For us and for our salvation, Christ became obedient unto death, even death on the cross. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Oh, sacred and now, O
Dear people of God, in this holy week, let us hear once more of our Lord's passion and death. With heart and mind, let us go to Gethsemane and to the halls of judgment, and yes, even to the hill of Calvary. Let us hear in Holy Scripture the story of God's loving purpose in Christ's suffering and his ultimate sacrifice for all humankind. But first, let us pray for the needs of the whole world, for peace and justice on earth, for the unity and mission of the church for which he died. Let us remember in Christ's name the poor and helpless, the cold, the hungry, and the oppressed, all who are sick and who mourn, the lonely and unloved, the aged and little children, as well as those who do not know and love the Lord Jesus Christ. We remember all those who rejoice with us, but upon another shore and in a greater light, that multitude which no one can number, whose hope was in the crucified and risen Lord. Let us pray that we may be taught humility as we remember Christ's humiliation, that we may be taught obedience as we remember Christ's obedience unto death, and that we might be taught to love one another as we remember Christ's love for all people. Finally, let us pray for all those things for which our Lord would have us ask as we pray the prayer of his heart. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.